meaning having gone to the other shore. Para means beyond, you know, having gone beyond. Itta is the past passive participle of the verb to go. I, one of the verbs to go. And so paramita means having gone beyond. And the Tibetans translated that as paralduchimba. So those are somewhat different. Perfect wisdom and transcendent wisdom are a bit different, because the wisdom transcendence has a double meaning. One, it's like the highest level of wisdom, which might be okay for perfect. But the other one is you've gone beyond possessing wisdom, because you've gone beyond the ordinary way of knowing things, because you have merged with all things that are by becoming a Buddha, where you know everything because you are everything. You're sort of like a CAT scan. You've CAT scanned the universe or something like that. So you don't know it in the way we normally think of wisdom or knowledge, as a kind of dualistic thing where, you know, I know that's a pillar because I have a word pillar, a concept of a pillar holding up a weight, et cetera, et cetera. And it's an external thing to me, and it's a subject-object thing. And maybe there's a secret idea that by knowing the name pillar, I've somehow controlled that. And I've owned that, like, you know, when you know it, when you name something, you kind of own it. You know, there's a whole ancient thing about that. Whereas the wisdom, transcendent wisdom, is definitely, you don't own it, you become one with it. So in a way, it owns you, the universe. You know, Buddha is owned by the universe because he is the whole universe. He identifies with all the other living beings. His enlightenment means like that, right? You are everyone. You know, like here and how you and I are sitting here looking out of our faces at other people. But if we were Buddhas, we would be all the people simultaneously, which is a weird idea. It's a very strange idea. But we do know that the human beings can identify with one or two other beings, you know, for teammates, you know, mother and child, lovers, brothers, sisters, you know, parents and children sometimes, or exceptionally. And we know that. I don't know why my eye is irritating. We know that, right? So I follow the Tibetan, I figure that the Sanskrit pundits, Mahayana Sanskrit pundits, and Tibetan masters who translated this into Tibetan, the reason that they chose going beyond is because this is wisdom goes beyond. Generosity that goes beyond. For example, generosity that goes beyond is a kind of generosity combined with wisdom that goes beyond, where you don't perceive yourself as the giver. You don't see the act of giving as something separate from you as the giver, and you don't see the recipient as someone separate from you as a receiver. So therefore, you don't even think of yourself as giving. It's the giving that is just so automatically generous that it's not, you know, it's not like, oh, I gave a gift, like, oh, they should be so happy, oh, they should say thank you, blah, 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 you know. So each one of the different 6 or 10 transcendences is like that. So it means like, I got it, it's perfect, it's, you know, I got perfect wisdom, I got perfect this and that. So I don't think that, I think that's not so good. But I haven't managed, it's so stuck in people's minds, they go on and on about perfect wisdom and perfections. So I haven't quite convinced everybody. Probably won't succeed until it's posthumous. Okay. Now, second thing is,